Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book, Straight Ahead, written by Adley Aiste, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Laughter, a Lubricant of Life. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Isaiah chapter 61, verse 3. It says, "To bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of His splendor." Children, here is a divine recipe, a wonderful prescription for those who mourn. One of time's outstanding examples of those who have learned to make laughter the lubricant of life is Abraham Lincoln. He had his share of sorrow. All his life he was dogged by misfortune. Yet he endured crushing pressures and criticism. Since he was born in a fourth floor cabin, he would be called a deprived person in modern sociological language. When you hear some classmate tell you that a fellow hasn't got a chance anymore and that he has decided to be a dropout, just remind him of Abraham Lincoln. When Abe was only 9, he stood beside the bed and watched his beloved mother die. Dennis Hanks was Abraham Lincoln's cousin. Years later, he remembered that night and told the story. It was the mother's final illness. She reached out her hand and tousled her boy's unruly, thick, black hair and said, "Abe, you be a good boy, you hear? And listen to the laughter that's in the world. Though sometimes, Abe, you'll have to listen real hard." All his life, he listened real hard to hear a bit of laughter. Often he had to create it himself. The late Roy D. Dunlap, former executive editor of TWA Ambassador magazine, often spoke and wrote about the humor of Abraham Lincoln. Mr. Dunlap said of Lincoln, "Laughter was the lubricant of Abraham's life, the essential oil which kept him going, which sustained his soul, his spirit, which saved him from insanity." When Lincoln's Secretary of War, Edward Stanton, called him a fool, Lincoln heard about it and laughed as he said, "Well, it must be so. I've never known him to be wrong." Children, what a great loss to the world if Lincoln, as a boy, had become discouraged and had given up and become a dropout instead of going straight ahead. Children, let us look for the oil and listen, even if we have to listen real heart. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, are you sad this morning? Are you worried? Then you can practice the recipe given by Mr. Abraham Lincoln, that you only need to hear laughter and try to listen to it. Children, remember the advice of Solomon's proverb that a cheerful heart is a good medicine, but a broken spirit dries up the bones. Therefore, let's fill this day with your happy laughter, so that your day will be a day full of joy and be a blessing to many people. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.